coming up on The Potter's Touch.
Like it or not, here I come. Celebrate me or not, here I come. Take pictures of me or not, here I come. When the water breaks and I get the opportunity and the doors open and the walls lurch and God says move, I'm going from faith to faith and from glory to glory. Touch five people, say, here I come, here I come, here I come.
This is the Potter's Touch.
Well, you know, we're excited. We have just been having an explosive experience at Woman Thou Art Loose that is absolutely incredible. To those of you that are just coming back, we've got more Woman Thou Art Loose for you. And to those of you who didn't get to go and you feel cheated, well, we're going to bring a little bit of Woman Thou Art Loose to you. It's 2013 Woman Thou Art Loose, but powerful nonetheless. God moved in an amazing way. I mean, amazing. Amazing way. He did incredible things. You're talking about Pastor Cheryl Brady, you're talking about Dr. Ivy Hilliard, you're talking about Dr. Jazz and myself pouring the Word of God into you, and it is awesome. And so we're going to bring you 2013 since you missed 2014 so that you can experience Woman Thou Art Loose too. We love you and we want you to be blessed. Let me hear from you as you are being blessed through the Word of God. Today I'm going to lead out the message with I'm in transition. Have you ever been there? Have you ever been in that place where you were trying to figure out what's next? This message will help you get there. Take a look. When you talk to women about birth, they immediately think about being mothers, but I didn't come to talk to you as mothers. I came to talk to you as babies who have outgrown the parameters of the womb that you live in. I came to talk to you as living creatures who have found restrictions in the place that you once found nurture and nourishment and found yourself in prison by narrow thinking people and narrow thinking circumstances and narrow evolving predicaments. I came to tell you that you cannot feed in one realm and stay in that realm, that if you get enough on the inside of you, you will find a discomfort in staying in the dimension that you once lived in. And I came to prepare your hearts and minds. If you're not prepared to go through some bloody stuff and some dirty stuff and some stinky stuff, you don't want to keep feeding on this kind of word, because if you feed on this kind of word, it will open up your mind and open up your thinking and open up your ideas and open up your concepts until all of a sudden you are uncomfortable in what you were once comfortable in. Some of you have already begun to experience it. You're thinking on another level, and it's causing a separation. Some of you have already begun to experience it, because what used to be funny isn't funny anymore. And what you used to enjoy, you don't enjoy anymore. And what you used to be satisfied with, you're not satisfied with anymore. And all of a sudden, you don't fit in the places you used to fit in, and you don't even understand it. And they think you're acting funny, and they think you're acting strange, and they say things like, you forgot where you came from. I didn't forget it, I just can't stay in it. Tweet that, I got to get out of here. I got to get out of here. I've got to get out of here. You tell your twin you can stay in there if you want to. This might be okay for you, but I got to get out of here. Even if I have to fight my way out like Jacob and Esau, I've got to get out there. If I've got to pull and tug, I've got to get out. I've got too much vision to stay in this rut. In this hole, in this roughage, in this barren place, I've outgrown it, I've outthought it,
I've outlived it. I have realized that this is not the world. It is only a world. I submit to you that birth and death are the wonder twins of divinity. That in scope, one is no different from the other. That in reality, God says that we should cry when they are born and rejoice when they die, because God understands that birth and death are labors together with Him to push you from one world. You'll get it when you get home. Just keep thinking on it. Just the baby dies out to the world it's in. Can't live. Death in the scriptures is separation. The baby is separated from the world it lives in, pushed out of it, gone from the world it lived in. To be absent over here is to be present over there. You can't be here and there. You can't be there and here. If you're going to go there, you can't stay here. So the moment the baby shows up here, he's absent there. And death stands over in the corner and says, same thing. To be absent in the body is to be present with the Lord. So birth stands over there and says, I am transportation into the next dimension. And death stands over here and says, so am I. But the text is not talking about the birth over here or the birth over there, but the many births that happen in between. Stay with me. Galatians says, my little children in whom I travail in birth again until Christ be formed in you. And we as Christians often use the term born again. But we should say born again, again, and again, and again. Because if you look back over your life, every so often, every so often, every so many days or situations or circumstances, you find yourself in a world that's too small and too tight and too limited, and you have to go through a birthing process from one dimension to get into the next dimension, and you are being born. Again. And again, you get comfortable, and as soon as you settle all in and say, now I got my life all nice and neat, and I finally got it just the way I want it, and oh, I've arrived, and I've reached my destination, and then you look around, and the water breaks in the situation, and the world begins to lurch, and all of a sudden you have to recreate yourself and find yourself starting all over again. You were sure of yourself over here, but now you're a student again over there. You knew how to do this, but now you're learning again how to do that, and you are born again. And if you look at this text literally, you lose the power of the text altogether, because Ezekiel isn't really talking to us about birth at all. He's talking to us about the trauma of transition. The trauma of transition. The absolute trauma of transition, not the trauma of the mother, the trauma on the traveler who dares to transition to the next dimension. Can I go deeper? This child gives me an illustration that is symbolic of an experience I had when I was in Kenya, in the bush out in Kenya, as the women began to talk to us about giving birth in the desert, in the dry sand. It was inconceivable to me to give birth without nurses and waiting rooms and music and machines and needles and stethoscopes and all of it. They said, no, we have our babies out here in the dirt, in the sand, in the heat. I thought, oh God. In perilous environments, traumatic circumstances, we give birth wherever the water breaks. You don't get to position yourself into a comfortable, nice, neat, air-conditioned room and have room service served to you to give birth. It happens where it happens. Touch somebody and say, it happens where it happens. I'm going to change where I change. I'm going to transition where I transition. Ready or not, here I come. Like it or not, here I come. Celebrate me or not, here I come. Take pictures of me or not, here I come. When the water breaks and I get the opportunity and the doors open and the walls lurch and God says move, I'm going from faith to faith and from glory to glory. Touch five people, say, here I come, here I come, here I come. But the Lord told me that he was going to bring women in here tonight who are in transition. Shake hands with somebody and say, I'm in transition. The hardest thing to do, the hardest thing to deal with, the hardest thing to manage, the hardest thing to put up with is transition. The thing we hate the most is transition. We hate it because it takes us out of our element. It takes us out of our comfort zone. It takes us out of the place where we are secure and sure, and we've learned how to manage and control everything. You cannot control everything when you are in transition. It is what it is. It happens like it happens. I can't get my hair done and do it. I can't be pretty about it. I got to come out any way I can. I'm in transition. I can't meet with the board or talk to the committee or get everybody to approve it. When my water breaks, get ready, here I come. If it's under a tree, if it's under a bush, if it's against the wall, when the water breaks, that's my sign, here I come. Touch your neighbor and say, move. I'm coming through. Move. I'm coming out. Move. I'm grown out of this spot. Move. I'm coming into another dimension. Move. I see a door opening for me. Move. I see divine permission to step. Move. I see the glory of God calling me. Move. You didn't hear me. I said, touch him and say, move. Every wall, every barrier, every restriction, every limitation, every obstacle, every stubborn thing that stood in my life and said, you've got to stay where you started, I command you in the name of Jesus. Somebody holler, move! Look at your neighbor and say, something is about to move in my life. In my hard place, in my stubborn place, in my place of resistance and defiance, something is about to.
Still to come on The Potter's Touch.
I want to talk to women in this room who are called to go into the next dimension, and you don't have the help that your sister has, and you don't have the support that your sister has, but God is going to let your water break, and you are coming into the next dimension any old way you can. Make some noise if you're here.
To get where God wants you, you have to be on the move.
What you used to be satisfied with, you're not satisfied with anymore. And all of a sudden, you don't fit in the places you used to fit in. They say things like, you forgot where you came from. I didn't forget it. I just can't stay in it.
With your gift of any size, you'll receive the message On the Move from Woman Thou Art Loosed on CD.
If I've got to pull and tug, I've got to get out. I've got too much vision to stay in this rut.
And when your gift is $75 or more, you'll receive the entire 6-DVD series Woman Thou Art Loosed at MegaFest.
Every stubborn thing that stood in my life and said, you've got to stay where you started. Somebody holler, move!
However, with your gift of $145 or more, you'll receive the On the Move gift set that includes a custom tote bag, the Woman Thou Art Loosed 6-DVD series, and the Colliding with Destiny and the Princess Within books. Move into your destiny today.
So the Bible says the birth went smooth. There was nothing wrong with the birth. The transition happened the way it was supposed to happen. There's no abnormalities with the child. There is no death in the mother. There is no disease in the child. There is no affliction in the mother. The baby is suffering not because the birth went wrong. The baby is suffering because it had to go into the next dimension without any help. I want to talk to women in this room who are called to go into the next dimension, and you don't have the help that your sister has, and you don't have the support that your sister has, but God is going to let your water break, and you are coming into the next dimension any old way you can. Make some noise if you're here. Touch your sister and say, it's not ideal, but I'm coming. It's not perfect, but I'm coming. It's not comfortable, but I'm coming. I may be bruised, but I'm coming. I may have to cry, but I'm coming. I may have to sacrifice, but I'm coming. I may have to crawl out on my hands and knees, but look out, devil, here I come. Can I go on a little deeper? Because this baby didn't have what other babies had, it looks like where it came from. It is in this realm looking like that realm. It is in a new position, but it still has an old mentality. It doesn't understand the protocol. It doesn't know who to call. It doesn't have the rules. It doesn't have the background. It doesn't have the pedigree. It just stepped into something. Don't even know how to dress for it. Don't know how to walk for it. Don't know who to call for it. Don't have relationships for it. But God just let something break open and the baby's coming to the next realm. With afterbirth still on it. After birth, still on it. I'm here, but I look like where I came from. I'm here, but I'm carrying some residue of my history over into my destiny. I made it over, but I'm still bruised by what I went through in the process to get to the next level. Don't judge me by how I look. Don't judge me by what I got on. Don't judge me by how I stand. I didn't have the help that you had to get where I'm trying to get. I had to come any old way I can. Slap your neighbor and say, move. Get out of my way. Get out of my way. I'll get the clothes later. I'll get the contacts later. I'll get the pedigree later. I'll get the background later. I'll get it all worked out in a minute. This is all new for me. I'm in a new place, at a new time, at a new stage in my life. I don't even know how I got here. God just opened up the window of heaven and poured me out a blessing. I want all the grateful, thankful women who made it against the odds to give God a crazy praise. I said a crazy. Thank you. the word tonight is for survivors. It is for survivors who got pushed into the next dimension. And you're there, and everybody sees you there, and they know you're there, and your haters hate that you're there. This word is for you. God said, I noticed that you had no midwife. Nobody sponsored you. Nobody can take credit for what happened in your life. You pushed down walls. There was some bleeding and some bruising. You're there, but it's messy. Nobody washed you, but you're there. Nobody salted you. In the Bible days, when they salted the baby, it was to expedite the healing. So you're there, but you're still hurting. You made it into the next realm, but you're traumatized by the transition. Bruised from the journey. You can't even tell anybody that you have made it into the next realm. Late at night when nobody's looking, you peruse the damage. Touch the bruises. You're thankful, but you're bloody. You're there, but you're bruised. You made it without water. You made it without salt. You made it without swaddling. You didn't even have the clothes for the place God was taking you into. You have problems that you can't pick up the phone and call just anybody to fix. You got scars that you can't tell anybody about, because if they knew that you had those kinds of scars, they would try to destroy you or send you back where you came from. The Lord told me to tell you. He said, tell my children, first, that you are not in this by yourself. Listen, 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 listen. He says, I passed by you, and I saw what your associates didn't see. I know your secrets. I saw your damages. I saw your bruises. And I know that you haven't been salted. You haven't been washed. And you haven't been comforted with the swaddling of being in a place that you don't have all the accoutrements that go along with the situation that you're in. You arrived, but your husband didn't make it. You arrived, but your daughter didn't go with you. You arrived, but your friends aren't with you. You arrived, but your family doesn't like you. You arrived, but you have no swaddling. You're there with your bad self, but you're naked. You're there with your strong self, but you're cold. You're there with your tenacious self, but you're bruised. Nobody even cut your cord. You arrived in a realm that you have not totally detached from. You're in your destiny, but you're still connected to your history. And when nobody sees you, you cry. You cry because you are still connected with where you came from. And the devil says you're going to die. There and bloody, there and bleeding, there and frustrated, too there to be here and too here to be there. He tries to kill you with the process. I'm gonna say that again. He tries to kill you with the process. And God said, when I pass by you, I didn't preach a sermon. I didn't write a book. I didn't even send a note. I said one thing to you. Live. I'm out of time. I've got to stop there, but it's been a real joy just to give you a taste of Woman Thou Art Losing, more importantly, a taste of the Word of God and how it will richly change your life and strengthen you and build you up and fortify you, give you an inheritance, the Bible said, among all them that are sanctified. I pray that God would bless you and strengthen you. You might need the whole series. Throw a woman or a loose party, get some pizza, get some salad, low-fat salad, bring your girlfriends over, have a great time and experience the Word of the Lord. I love you with the love of the Lord. Take care of yourself.
To get where God wants you, you have to be on the move.
What you used to be satisfied with, you're not satisfied with anymore. And all of a sudden, you don't fit in the places you used to fit in. They say things like, you forgot where you came from. I didn't forget it. I just can't stay in it.
With your gift of any size, you'll receive the message On the Move from Woman Thou Art Loosed on CD.
If I've got to pull and tug, I've got to get out. I've got too much vision to stay in this rut.
And when your gift is $75 or more, you'll receive the entire 6-DVD series Woman Thou Art Loosed at MegaFest.
Every stubborn thing that stood in my life and said, you've got to stay where you started. Somebody holler, move!
However, with your gift of $145 or more, you'll receive the On the Move gift set that includes a custom tote bag, the Woman Thou Art Loosed 6-DVD series, and the Colliding with Destiny and the Princess Within books. Move into your destiny today.
Squeeze that hand. She came out of it. She came over it. She rose above it. She went through it. She made it out. But God's gonna put some salt on her tonight. God's gonna wash away some afterbirth tonight. Tonight is a night that God cuts the cord in your life. Squeeze that hand. You just touched a miracle. You just touched a testimony.
This is the Potter's Touch.